Hey there, and welcome to this video. Today I will talk about NumPy and how one can test whether two arrays are more or less equal. What you see here is the official documentation of NumPy, and specifically we are in the testing sub-package. It contains multiple assert functions that one can use to compare different objects like NumPy arrays. In this video, I'm going to show you how some of them work and what are the details when it comes to their behavior. All right, first of all, let me just show you what version of NumPy I have. So as you can see, it is 1.20, just in case there are some inconsistencies between versions. And now let me create a test script. First of all, let us define a function that generates four arrays that are more or less equal, but they differ in some aspects. So this function returns two arrays. First of them is the reference one. The second one is going to be the same as the reference one plus a very small constant. The third one is going to be identical to the reference one. However, we are going to prepend a dimension to it. And finally, the last array is again going to be the same as the reference one. However, one element of it is going to be set equal to not a number. All right, so the A array is just a simple NumPy array with two rows and three columns. The A eps is going to be the reference array plus a very small constant. A dim is going to be the A array, the reference array. However, we prepend it with one additional dimension. So effectively, this is the final shape, 1, 2, 3. And finally, we create the not a number array, which is a copy of the reference one. However, the element 01 is going to be set to not a number. All right, now the goal is to write multiple tests, and each of them will be focusing on one way how one can compare arrays. Here we are trying to compare two arrays using the equal equal operator of Python. As you can see, the test failed. The reason for this is that the dunder equal operator is defined element wise. The next test is going to use the element wise equality together with the all method. Here we run four different checks to better understand how the comparison mechanism works. Here we see that the second comparison failed. The reason for this is that the equal equal operator looks for exact equality, and one cannot allow any differences. So even if the arrays differ only by a small constant, they are still different. Let me also try to rerun the same test, however, let me pass the verbose flag. As you can see here, we get an element by element comparison of what the differences are. First of all, let me point out that the third check actually passed, and the reason for this is that NumPy did some broadcasting in the background. And finally, the last check failed, and that is because NumPy not a number is not equal to itself. Let me just show you what I mean. So to summarize, this similarity check is not able to handle when elements of the two arrays are close but not equal. It also does not recognize when there are extra dimensions. And lastly, it cannot deal with not a number. Let us now write another test using the NumPy's array equal. Right. We see that it's not able to handle the small epsilon. However, compared to the previous test, it is able to detect that A and A dim have different dimensions. When it comes to the not a number test, we can see that by default, it evaluates to false. However, we can provide an optional argument equal not a number and set it equal to true. And if we do this, all elements that are not a number will be considered the same. So to summarize, we can see that the NumPy's array equal function is able to detect different shapes. And if we want, it can also work with not a number. Here we consider the NumPy's function all close. Here we see that we pass the epsilon check, and that is simply because we set absolute tolerance equal to our epsilon. Unfortunately, when it comes to the extra dimension, all close was not able to detect it. And similarly to array equal, one can choose how the not a number is going to be handled. One thing to note here is that the assert array equal will already raise an assertion error if the check is not satisfied. This is different from what we did before because the previous checks return a boolean and then we needed to assert whether that boolean is true or false. Anyway, let us try the test. We see that the second check failed, and this is again because this specific function does not allow for any differences whatsoever. Also note that the error looks totally different, and namely we can see that we have a nice overview of what went wrong. Specifically, we see how many elements mismatched, we see the maximum absolute difference, and we see the maximum relative difference. The third check failed as well, and we can see that the error message is telling us that there's a mismatch in shapes. To summarize, this function handles not a number by default. It doesn't allow the two arrays to have small differences and mismatching shapes. And finally, we try the assert all close function. The first two checks passed, and the third one failed, and that is because the shapes are not matching. And we see that the not a number check also passed. Just for completeness, let me point out that you can disable the functionality of handling not a number by providing this flag. To summarize, this all-close function is able to handle small differences in the elements, and it's also able to handle not a number elements. Lastly, it doesn't allow for different shapes. I created a small table that is summarizing the behavior of all the functions I described. Personally, I find some of these behaviors not that intuitive. And finally, let me point out that NumPy has many other functions that are able to make comparisons of arrays. In this video, I just decided to go for these because I'm familiar with them. Anyway, that's it for the video. Thank you for making it to the very end, and I'll see you next time.